So these are the colors I'm going to be using. This is for the battery box, air box, bash plate, foot pegs. This is for the front and rear mudguard, satin white. I will be doing like a paint scheme on the bike. I'm thinking Kawasaki green with some white and maybe gold stripes or grey stripes. I haven't decided yet. So I'm going to paint the bash plate and the air box with the black, and it's going to sit in hot water for 5 minutes. It helps the paint flow out of the can.
Before it's too late.
dents. Okay, so this is the spare tank that came with the bike. Doesn't have any holes in it. It's got a few dents, but that's all right. Bit of a clean up and it'll come up pretty good. There's no like major holes, it's just light surface rust, which is good. So if you have a look, one side's pretty good. It's just got small little ding here, which is pretty good for a tank, spare tank. Have a look inside. I'm gonna have to clean up this rust. The tank that was on that original KE175, that was pretty badly rusted inside. Oh, it can be fixed, but I'm just gonna use this one. So what I'm gonna do, as you can see in here, there's a bit of surface rust. I saw a video on YouTube, and gonna fill it with vinegar and leave it sit for a day or two. And apparently, yeah, it cleans it right out. So that's what we're gonna do. Fill it with vinegar, let it soak for a couple of days, and then drain it out, flush it out with water, and I don't know what to do after that, whether I just give it a bit of a fill up with petrol or methylated spirits, and then just so if I can keep it in storage without having to rust again, because if I leave it empty, it's going to get surface rust. Anyone knows, yeah, feel free to comment. Open to any suggestions. So you just got some cheap vinegar from the supermarket. It was like $1.80 or something in a bottle. I'll fill that up. And I think the video, I watched a few videos of people doing this motorcycle gas tank thing with vinegar, and I think, I'm pretty sure they put pebbles or some stones in there and gave it a shake around while the vinegar was in there. That was like after it's been sitting for, say, a day, then they put these rocks in there and gave the tank a shake, and then they poured everything out, and I was pretty impressed with the result. It's already 6 liters. I've got 4 bottles. Might have to prop this up a little bit. Prop that up. Probably get a quarter of a bottle. Fill it right to the brim. Right to the cap. Make sure my fuel tap's off. That's it. We'll let that sit for a day. I'll check it in the morning. I don't want to leave it too long. I don't know how strong this vinegar is. I don't want it to put holes like acid does if you leave it for too long. But we'll come and check it in the morning. But that's the tank that's going on the KE175. Give it a sand up and a clean up. I might fill in the holes with some filler, some body filler. The tank's going to be green. Similar to the old classic Kawasaki green. Yeah, if anyone knows the paint code, that would be really good. Because I just got a color swatch from the paint auto paint shop and just tried to match a color. I wasn't too fussy for it to be exact. Okay, so this is the spare fuel tank that came with the bike. It's in better condition than the other one. The other one is repairable. However, it has a lot of rust inside and has a few holes. So I'm going to use this one. It's in a little bit better condition. So I filled it with vinegar, white vinegar, left it for 1 week. Just cheap stuff, filled it right up, left it for 1 week, and looks pretty good in there. So what I'm going to do is empty it to about half a tank, and then drop these, we'll place these pebbles inside and give it a shake around. I've seen this done a few times on YouTube, and it seemed to have worked for the people that have done it, so I'm going to give it a go myself. That a shake around. Now the fun part's to get the stones out of the tank.
Thank you.
That's it, pull out. Wow, that looks pretty good inside. Have a look at this. That's amazing. It actually worked. Pretty cool. Better than it was a week ago. That's awesome. Let's see if we can get a torch in there. I'm using hot water. Cold water would do, but I've just got a hot water attachment. Right side on the hill. Let it flush out till clean water comes out. Pretty good. Amazing what you can learn on YouTube from other people. Free education. Excellent. And we'll leave that to dry out in the sun. Once most of the tank's dried inside, I will fill it up with some clean engine oil. I'll probably give it about half a tank. Just so it doesn't start rusting again while it's being worked on. I'll probably just fill it with oil, give it a shake around, then pour the oil out. Okay, so next bit is the gas tank. We're going to strip it with some paint stripper. It's in a gel type form, and brush it on, leave it for 20-30 minutes, and you can either scrape it off, or I like to use the pressure washer or a hose, gets it off quicker. So we're going to do the tank front guard and one of the side guards where the oil tank is for the oil injection. can see. Okay, so we've stripped the paint and now we're gonna use some wet and dry sandpaper. Start with 80 grit to get off all the rough bit of paint, and then we'll work it down to, I don't know, 240 or something, then to 400, and then get it smoothed out, and then primer. So the tank and the mud guard for the front and the side guard cover plate for the injection tank. Okay, so I've given the tank a sand with some wet and dry. Started with 80 and worked all the way up to 400. It's got a bit of bog on it that was hiding under the paint, but I'm not really fussed. There's a few dents which I might fill in and just tidy up a little bit with some body filler. So what I'm going to do to this tank, I'm going to treat it with 415 metal ready, metal prep, on the inside of the tank as well as the outside before it gets a coat of primer. And you've got the front mud guard there, which I've also gone over with wet and dry sandpaper. And that's ready for undercoat. And the side cover for the oil tank for the injection pump. I did a bit of a mistake, which I probably won't do again. I won't use paint stripper on any of the plastic parts. So I let it sit for a bit too long and it softened the plastic a bit, which wasn't a problem. It's just when I used the gurney or the high pressure washer, it pitted the surface a little bit. So I'm going to have to fill that with a bit of putty, a bit of body filler. But I'm not going to be too fussy with it because it's not a show and shine bike. This is going to be used at the track. So, so we'll get these in some undercoat and then I'll be ready for top coat tomorrow.